Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Samson Igiebo. I'm an indigenous of Edo State, though I am domiciled in Delta State. I am actually concerned about the present political upheavals that is, or that has ignited, or that is already ignited in my state. And as a major stakeholder, I believe that I have a responsibility to contribute my quota, my unbiased quota, to the economic and political well-being of my state, Edo State. First and foremost, I want to address the issue of the current incumbent governor of the state, the person of Governor Godwin Inoegase Obaseki, and the Edo People Movement, EPM per se, and their leading opposition to the governor, who happens to be Pastor Osagie Ezejiawu. There is this assertion, there is this philosophical assertion that says that those who forget history are condemned to repeat its mistakes. It is on this premise that I want to bring out some very mind-blowing observation and to also make some clarification and then bring issues to the front burner for rational reasoning persons to actually decide or evaluate the situation in order for us to know exactly where we are going. Without any sentiment, I want to personally commend the governor of the state, the governor of Edo State, the person of Governor Godwin Inoegase Obaseki, who to many rational Edo persons, Edo people, is performing credibly and excellently well. He has been able to demonstrate competence, transparency, responsibility, innovation, creativity, and what have you. Governor Inoegase Obaseki have demonstrated responsive leadership. I remember the other time that when he was campaigning for the office of the governor, then the former governor happens to be the national chairman of APC, who is Adanso Somole, Commander Adanso Somole. And there were some very credible things he said about Governor Inoegase Obaseki. Very credible. And in that campaign, he said Obaseki was the steering behind his administration wheel that was able to ensure that he achieved a lot in actualizing his campaign promises and bringing to bear democratic tenets that today that Edo State is proud of. And that Obaseki is being brought, or is bringing Obaseki to the scene in order for him, or in order for the governor to consolidate on his achievement. And I don't think Obaseki has not done that. Obaseki have lived up to that expectation. But the question that is agitating now is, why this political tussle? What has Governor Obaseki done wrong that the incumbent chairman of APC, who happens to be the former governor, Comrade Adanso Shumole, wants him out by all costs. What is Obaseki's offense? It is a question that is still agitating the minds of so many of us. Now, what is this offense? What offense? What offense has this man actually committed? That you have to go and bring someone that you condemned with very grievous, not just shallow, very grievous, not allegations, not accusations, grievous statement that some of us have to go and do a lot of findings, and we discover that most of what Oshumule said about his exam, we're all fast and we're true. Was it the issue of how he didn't attend the school of law? Or the issue of baiting another fellow student with acid, and his involvement with the fake government of Lucky Benedion and others. So the question is that all these allegations, or what will I call it, allegation or whatever accusation that the governor has made or the former governor has made concerning Ezeh Jamu, that Edo people saw and said, no, we have to go with the governor, we have to go with Oshumole. Oshumole have said the right thing. What has changed? Has Oshumole now come out, just like my friend Prince Card said, has Oshumole now come out now to debunk what he previously said about Ezeh Jamu? What will now make Oshumole to even deny his former deputy the APC ticket, and every other person that was denied the ticket just for Ezeh Jamu, that he condemned initially, to now pick the consensus ticket of EPM. Edo people, there is more than meet the eyes. I want to say it beyond every reasonable doubt, and I'm ready to engage any persons who want to come up with rational reasons to debunk whatever I'm saying right now. I want to say that whatever that the former governor is doing and his EPN co-travelers are not for the interest of our state. There is more to what meets the eyes. It is not in the interest of our state. These people have an evil agenda. These people are not after the well-being of our state. I just watched Pastor Sage Jemu a few hours ago on channels, and I was just laughing. That look at a man. What I see there, well, sorry to say, let me not use some very derogatory language, but to some of us who are enlightened, to some of us who reason rationally, to some of us who evaluate situations before making decisions and conclusions, we know that we have gravitated beyond the stage that we can never be deceived. We can never be deceived. We can never be deceived. We can't. All this, whatever method that the former governor is using now to ensure that Obaseki is oozed out of the race, I want to tell you that it is the will of the people that will still decide. Whatever APC National Working Committee want to do, or whatever may be Oshumole input to ensure that the so-called, in quote, Ezeh Jamu carries the day, we will not let the governor know that. I remember when Oshumole was governor then, he used to come up with a margin. He said, let the people lead. We will also actually demonstrate to the governor that actually the people will lead in this one. The people will prevail. The governor has not done anything wrong. You know, the governor has not done anything wrong, and he has every right to seek a second tenure to consolidate on his achievement so far. He has not done anything wrong. And to those of us who are domiciled in other states, we are going to use the little of what we have to ensure that the governor carries that day. Evil, like Oshumole have always said, that evil cannot prevail over good. Darkness cannot prevail over light. All these EPN people and their co-travelers are just after, their own is that the governor should serve them. They should control the governor. The resources of the state should be their own.
When Oshiomhole was governor, he would never take this from any man. And that was why he dismantled godfatherism in his, during his tenure as the governor of the state. So why is he now trying to replicate? Why is he now trying to attract what he attacked initially? It will never see the light of day. Edo State is our state. We are indigenous. We are major stakeholders. By the grace of God, I am a registered voter in Edo State. If Godwin Obaseki does not carry the day, I bet you what happened in Benue, where the governor on his own left the party and contested in another party and won, the will of the people will prevail. Oshiomhole and his EPN co-travelers, I repeat, they will be disappointed and they will be disgraced. They will be disappointed. Politics, I don't know all these people, all these EPN people. Sometimes I ask them, what is their business? Do they have any other business apart from politics? What is their business? Some of them who are lawyers have left their chambers. Some of them who are farmers have left their occupation. So they have not taken politics as their personal business. Whatever it might be their agenda, will never carry the light of day. Thank you and God bless.